South Africa. South Africa.
Everybody uses black and white to try to draw the line between wrong and right. But if you use your eyes to really see, you know we don't see realistically. Because skin that's white is really a pain, so either you can't see or I can't think. Skin that's black is really a frown, but that don't make the world go round. To put a color on skin, to me, is a sin. That's why apartheid must never win. We must put an end to this, my friend, and it should never be allowed to happen again. It's time to wake up and do some good to try to see each other the way we should. Because looking at the people, I sometimes find that Sun City is in the mind.
I was watching TV the other night, and who should appear but, you know, like Walter Concrete with the blues. And it occurred to me how much of our vocabulary we seem to get from TV nowadays, calling things whatever they call them, even if it's correct. The first thing that occurred to me was like third world, you know, like you ask somebody from here, like, where's the third world? They might say, oh yeah, man, I know, it's a disco. You go about three blocks and take a left. Or they might tell you the third world is a new health food restaurant. I know the first time I heard there was trouble in the Middle East, I thought they were talking about Pittsburgh.
Let me see your ID. Let me see your ID.
Let's get down to the real nitty gritty. Talk about the crimes in Sun City. Let's get down to the real nitty gritty. Talk about the crimes in Sun City. A city of diamond, city of gold, city of sorrows with horrors untold. But even a fool should be able to tell Sun City a charade for hell.
It's the death, it's called genocide. People dying to defeat, it's called apartheid. It's the death, you won't get out alive. There's no place to run, there's no place to hide. South Africa, that's what I said. Cause if you talk about the government, you're better off dead. South Africa, starvation right here. Politicians and leaders living in fear. South Africa, we don't need apartheid. If you ain't got no money, stay the hell outside. South Africa, from coast to coast, colored people got the least, white people got the most.
And the word casualties comes up a lot. And in South Africa, they seem to make it feel like there's a battle against, between isms going on, between one good ism and one bad ism. But what they're talking about is nightly South Africans died casualties. There were 8 more casualties in South Africa. Nothing casual about dying. Nothing casual about standing for freedom. My grandmother used to say, if you don't stand for something, you'll go for anything. We stand against apartheid. Stand against apartheid.
Let me see you, I do. Let me see you, I do.
But we're sick and tired of what we heard.
Think apartheid is quite absurd. Prejudice is the reason people have died. Yes, prejudice stands for apartheid.
So we all get together to lend a hand to bring people to peace all across the land.
We've got to stop running like I've ever tried. And all this we have got to stop. We're the three fat boys.
And we're here to say
we're gonna stop apartheid.
And I always.
I had never met anyone from Southern Africa until I started going to school. I was going to Lincoln University down in Pennsylvania. There were South African refugee students there who were, many of them were athletes, and we started to compare experiences and stuff. And they were telling me that when you walk around in South Africa, you gotta carry this little black book with you that tells everybody whether you're supposed to be in a given area or not. Damn, there's a parallel in my life, because I got to do that when I go to Philly.
Let me see you, I do. Let me see you, I do.
Yeah. We are waiting for the day that I will fade away. Some people say, let's say Caucasus race. Some people say, let's say Mongolian race. Some people say, let's say Negro race. We don't believe.
Multiple ways. All you know is the human race. apartheid's a crime. In the color fact, they won't bother the mind. The majority rules against the fools, and all those who oppose will become uncool. I'm talking about a place they call Sun City. Las Vegas in the desert, in a town without pity. South Africa, yes, the motherland. No human rights for the African. Cause Sun City's bright lights, no, down their rights. And ain't nothing else to do but stand up and fight. Now if I ruled the world and was king on the throne, I'd stop this mess in my sweet home.
You see, the thing about I ain't going to Sun City is that somehow by the South African government, Sun City is described as though it's somewhere else, not connected to South Africa or apartheid. It's like somebody in Manhattan trying to describe the Bronx to you as another country, as though it is no longer connected to New York.
Let me see your ID. Let me see your ID. Let me see your ID. Let me see your ID.
That it's all in their conscience, it's all in their minds. Let's all lend a hand to fight against apartheid. South Africa must be free. Quality and justice, a people's liberty. Except for no money, I would never play Sun City.
The most important thing is to not be misrepresented and to not be misinterpreted when it comes to our feelings on this. Other than that, I was watching TV again and I seen that Falwell had been a representative of the American people over in South Africa, over there taking a fall for somebody. Somebody in here said, hey, what about the separation between church and state? I said, especially this church and that state, we stand against apartheid.
Let me see your ID.
They start by shaking your hand and then they hold you back as much as they can. They try to keep you weak from getting strong, because they know if they're strong, you're gonna change what's wrong. Ban my voice, ban it now, like Stevie Wonder, I'ma speak out loud. Cause where you live is where you stand, and you shouldn't get checked by any man. Even if they got a stick in their hand, that still don't mean that they're in command. Yo, yo, I'm the man called Scorpio, and if you didn't know, you will know. I hate prejudice and communists, cause I'm an optimist of all this mess. Take that.